state where you lose control. Dunedin man Mark Cummings reached his at the end of a torturous 2 years in which he lost his daughter, his marriage, and eventually his mind. His resulting rampage made national headlines and saw this once successful businessman imprisoned. Here's Rebecca Wright, and a warning, the story has some disturbing themes.
I was probably the angriest I've ever been. I remember thinking that, well, this is it, this has come to a head. You're gonna hear a bit of my rage, you know?
Mark Cummings had reached his breaking point.
It sounds like you went crazy that day.
Yeah, I did, yeah.
Rampaging through the Dunedin City Council offices in March, it was the culmination of months of tragedy, frustration, and grief.
What I've gone through after losing my daughter, like, it, I wouldn't wish it on anybody.
Just 2 years ago, life was very different. Mark was married with three children, successful, optimistic about the future.
I had a lifetime ahead of me of grandchildren and new houses and parties and boyfriends and 21sts and who knows what sort of dramas, because there probably would have been a few, but...
How would you describe Mark? You're his mum.
He's fun-loving, hard-working, bit of a rat bag. Yeah, but basically a good person.
Mark's mum, Jean, and his sister, Chanel.
He's ambitious. He's got this entrepreneurial knack, which a very hard worker. Yeah, he was a good dad. Yeah.
Mark's eldest daughter, Jade, was 15, and she and Mark were close.
Sort of daddy's girl?
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
What was she like?
Full of energy. She was friendly, sociable, typical teenager, really, yeah.
She was just starting to branch out into life and friends and
makeup, eyebrows,
boys, horses. And she did like to push the boundaries. She wasn't a girl that liked to hear no.
Tuesday, September 17th, 2019, was the day that everything changed.
Jade had just finished school and I'd got home from work and it was about 4 o'clock. That was the last time I seen her. I went out one door to go out the back and Jade had got changed and gone out the front door in the space of 10 minutes and I didn't know where she'd gone.
Jade had gone on a car ride with a 17-year-old boy she'd recently met. He'd just bought a powerful new ute and was driving on a restricted license, which meant he shouldn't be taking passengers yet. Jade's decision to jump in would have devastating consequences.
Well, Jade Cummings was the passenger in a ute travelling down a side road towards this intersection. The teenage driver failed to stop, ploughing straight through and into an oncoming car. Both Jade and the driver of the oncoming car were killed in that collision, and the teenage driver suffered critical injuries.
It's every parent's worst nightmare.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. It has totally changed us for the worst that day.
It's a lot of shock, a lot of disbelief. We actually could not believe that this had happened.
Days later, the Cummings family were burying a child who had walked out the door one day and never come back.
1,500 kids and friends turned up. Quite honoured for Jade that she had so many people there.
But in the days after the funeral, the questions began for Jade's family.
We went out to the scene and found all sorts of bits and pieces, and we were trying to piece it together there. And how did this happen?
They discovered that the intersection stop signs on the side road that Jade and her friend were driving on were overgrown on the day of the accident.
In this situation, with the stop signs overgrown by the vegetation, It's clearly not an acceptable condition.
Matt King is a forensic accident investigator who is familiar with this case.
You know, you've got this occluded country road, you've got these stop signs overgrown by vegetation, you've got a young driver. So was this just an accident waiting to happen?
When the stop sign is blocked by the bushes, then he potentially doesn't see the stop sign or sees it too late to actually avoid entering the intersection without stopping. And it actually becomes unavoidable for the driver at that point as well. So then, whose fault is it?
It is the Dunedin City Council's responsibility to ensure that these stop signs are clearly visible. At the time of the crash, they were obscured by vegetation, and local residents had recently complained that they were unsafe.
Yeah, it's not uncommon on quiet country roads like this for people to miss stop signs they're not expecting, especially if they're covered by bushes, and blow through the intersection. So how many times has someone missed that intersection and not had an accident prior to this?
And the stop signs were also undersized for this location.
The council's never apologized, never discussed anything about the problems with the intersection. There was just nothing at all from them, which just didn't really sit well anyhow.
It just makes me incredibly angry that they're so arrogant, ignorant, and I believe they should have been changed. That intersection should have been made safe.
Several months later, the teenage driver of the ute pleaded guilty to careless driving causing death.
I was pleased he had been charged and it wasn't just failing to stop.
But it didn't resolve things for you?
No, not at all.
Why not?
People were softening me up even then at that stage that potentially there'd be no jail time.
That's because of the age of the driver and the fact he was being dealt with by the youth justice system.
I was really after my pound of flesh. I thought he'd done me wrong, and I thought I'd get justice for Jade. I thought Jade deserved that.
Mark needed help with his grief. He didn't get help with his grief, nor did he get answers.
Ruth Money is a victim advocate supporting the Cummings family.
Yeah, it's quite normal, right? You've lost your daughter. You want answers. You want to understand what happened. You have questions and you need them answered.
What's Mark's mental state like by this time?
He was not coping. None of us were coping, but he seriously was lost. Just
as if that wasn't enough, Mark's marriage was disintegrating too.
Rock bottom just kept on getting lower and lower. Each time we thought we'd hit rock bottom, something else would happen.
He had lost everything. Lost his family, lost Jade. And in the meantime, we are desperately trying to get him some health, mental health care.
And you knew he needed help?
Oh, absolutely. We took him to A&E. We took him to the psych service. It was just awful because we were trying so hard to get him some help and we couldn't get anything.
He was imploding, I reckon. He was just...
Yeah, he just...
So your daughter's dead, and you still don't really understand what happened that day?
No, not at all.
That must be torture.
It's just so mixed up. It's ruined my marriage. It's ruined everything.
You've lost...
Everything.
Everything?
Yeah.
In March of this year, the young driver was sentenced and he received permanent name suppression and an absolute discharge, meaning that the offence was wiped from his record. The judge described him as an otherwise responsible, maturing young man getting on with his life and ordered that the victim's families be notified within 3 days of his decision. But the police officer in charge never notified Mark Cummings.
I read it in the Otago Daily Times that he'd had a clean slate, everything wiped, and when I read it at 6 o'clock on Monday morning, I lost the plot.
At 9:45 a.m. on March 30th this year, Mark Cummings walked into reception at the Dunedin City Council offices and went berserk.
What do you remember about that moment?
I was in rage. I was past the point of rage.
fuelled by diazepam medication, Mark tore apart the council's offices, destroying everything in his path as frightened staff fled.
Why did you do that?
I believe that Jade had got no justice. I felt that I was the laughing stock of Dunedin and couldn't protect my family, and no one was listening to me.
Why were you so focused on the Dunedin City Council?
I see the Dunedin City Council just let me down at every time and continue to put the boot in with their denial of any responsibility.
Mark's frenzy lasted 4 minutes before he was eventually pepper sprayed and arrested by armed police.
I think Mark wanted to die that day. I think he had had a guts full of everything. And I think he would have been happy to be with Jade.
We don't condone any of it. He was pushed to the limit.
Mark pleaded guilty to threatening to kill the judge, the teenage driver, and his parents, and willful damage resulting from his attack. He was held in prison for 5 months awaiting bail before finally being released to electronic monitoring at his mum's place.
How do you feel now about what you did that day?
Deeply embarrassed and ashamed. And
those people in that building would have been terrified.
I'm truly sorry for the pain and hurt I've caused the people, the staff at the DCC on the day.
Mark's made some terrible decisions. He's also paid an incredibly high price. Not only did he lose his daughter, but he has spent 5 months incarcerated. He's got two children. He wants to get his life back on track. He wants a job. He wants to contribute to the community. He wants this over.
The Dunedin City Council declined to be interviewed on camera for this story, but 2 years after the accident that claimed two lives here, it has finally installed new stop signs. Mark Cummings has had a lot of time to reflect on that day and the teenage driver involved in the accident.
I'd like to apologise to the young driver and to his parents for the stress I've caused them and the pain and the worry. If it was a tragic accident, I wish him to get on with his life and, you know, always remember Jade and what might have been or what could have been.
Now he's trying to move on and focus on the life he has and not the one he's lost.
I'm just so sorry how everything's turned out. I live with a bit of regret now. So the future's, I believe it will be better and brighter than the last 2 years.
Well, Mark Cummings will be sentenced for his rampage on December 8th. Jade's death and that of the other man killed will be part of a coronial inquiry expected to happen next year. Police say they extend their sympathies to the victims' families and also say they're unable to comment on this incident while the IPCA investigates. But if there are things to be learnt, they will put them into practice.